Welcome to the Near Memo, a weekly conversation about search, social, and commerce. What happened, why it matters, and the implications for local.
Hello, everybody. Welcome back to the Near Memo with me, Mike, and today our special guest, Adam Dorfman, the new VP of Product at Reputation. Is that the correct title, Adam?
That is correct, and thank you.
Yes, congratulations
on that
well-deserved promotion. I've been watching your career from afar. No, I'm
kidding. Not from that far, anyway, I'd say.
Anyway, we talk every week about search, social, and commerce through a local lens. And Adam is kind enough to be sitting in for David Mim, who's off playing golf or riding SpaceX to the next destination or wherever he is. Do you know where David is? I don't know where he is.
I assume he's drinking beer somewhere on a golf course.
Well, it's probably too early for him since he's on the West Coast. So unless he's got a serious drinking problem, which I'm unaware of. Okay. All right. Having said that, we're going to move on. And, you know, a lot of stuff happened this week. As always, we pick three items and then unpack them and see where that discussion takes us. And today I'm going to lead off with the rumor that Apple would be introducing some sort of search engine or new search capability at their developer conference, WWDC, which starts on Monday, I believe. And so, you know, over time, Apple has put more and more investment into search. Siri is a search engine of sorts. Spotlight Search is a search engine. And they have continued to improve that and kind of peel away, I think, some of the volume that Google might see. We don't have any numbers on that, but there is some usage of these things, and so we're kind of speculating on whether or not, and I wrote about this week, we're going to see anything new, or whether we're just going to see some sort of incremental improvement of the capability. So what do you guys think?
The rumor was specifically about, I think, a web-based search.
Yeah, a standalone search engine.
Yeah. Yeah. And as I said here, listening to you, the one reason I think Apple would do it is because they think that the only time they break things out of their ecosystem, for example, TV Plus, music, et cetera, is when they think it can be a lever to bring people into their ecosystem. And it is conceivable to me that search, a private search, where the experience is really good and the results are really good, et cetera, could do that to Apple. But for the most part, I see them as device-based, as you called it, federated search, where search is just a feature within the device. And I have a little hard time envisioning going out of that frame for this, although it is conceivable.
You know, I was thinking about this, and when I think about Apple, one of the ten poles that they always lay a stake to, whatever the phrase is privacy, right? And I think often about how they are constantly pushing privacy rights. And then I also think about like search engines, up and coming search engines like DuckDuckGo. And I think I would be surprised if they launch a web-based search engine without some sort of acquisition happening at the same time. Because we all know search is really hard to get right. Even to get to, like, it's easy to get to 80% right, but to get that last 20% is incredibly difficult. And a lot of companies have struggled with it. But if they could somehow roll this into their privacy push, I could see it building more trust with customers that care about that. And I could also see it potentially making a bigger difference from in the search industry as a whole as well, too.
I think they're the only party that has the capacity to really capture meaningful search volume from Google at this point. It would be through the iPhone.
Right. It was just announced this week, and I think you wrote about it in the newsletter, that Safari is at 1 billion users.
Yeah, right.
And Safari, the URL bar in Safari is a pretty powerful search tool that I use all the time because it gives me the I Feel Lucky result from Apple. It gives me my Google result. It gives me any open tabs I might have, which is a huge issue, is spawning tabs. And it allows me to search the page. So the Safari search bar is a very powerful tool. Do either of you use it a lot?
Yeah.
I do.
So that's powerful. The question is whether how would Apple push that out into the web, right? They didn't push maps onto the web. They kept it largely as a Macintosh iOS thing.
And I think the other thing too, it's a good point, Mike. When you think of Windows users, that when they start using Chrome or Edge or whatever the current Microsoft web browser is by default, Google still has, what, 90, 95% search share as it relates to search. Yep. So even if Apple was to launch a web-based search browser, are people still going to use Google anyways, even if they default to the new search engine that Apple launches? I think mobile is a different story, but desktop seems like a search.
I don't think they need to launch a desktop offering. I mean, I think the current stuff that Apple is doing around search is useful, but it doesn't replace Google. If they wanted to do something that's sort of positioned as a Google replacement, I don't think they need to go onto the web. They can just have it be device-based, as you said, Mike. I think it would be pretty interesting. I've sort of long believed that if they were going to get serious about search, they would buy somebody like Neva or DuckDuckGo or somebody, even though those guys are, I guess, relying to some degree on the Bing index, is my understanding. I'm not 100% sure about that. But, I see Apple's motivations being, I mean, beyond what you said, Mike, about bringing new people into the ecosystem, you know, completing the privacy equation for them, kind of having a more, that this is kind of a hole in a way in that whole iPhone privacy marketing kind of bundle. And this is what you were saying, Adam. There's also a revenue opportunity for them. You know, they've been making more and more money with the search ads on the App Store. In fact, Facebook and others are critical of them, you know, kind of shifting revenue from third parties onto their own platform through app tracking transparency. And I think as Tim Cook looks to grow services revenue as one of the sort of drivers of additional growth, search advertising could be very lucrative for them. They could do a very simple, you know, search ad product, and it might be effective. But again, I don't think we're going to see any standalone, you know, new announcements. I think we'll see some incremental improvements of what already exists in all likelihood.
Instead of I feel lucky result in Safari, they'll give us two results. They'll double their exposure.
Thanks for joining David, Mike, and Greg. To stay on top of the latest developments in local, subscribe to our newsletter at nearmedia.co. We'll see you next week.